balance, way out of position, allowing Mahmudbekov to really finish. Trying to spell and talk at the same time. Allow him to finish that beautiful Uchimata. Okay. So we have a couple repechage matches coming up. Van de Meyberg. We'll go ahead and finish watching this one. Looks like Sterpa is going to hold on to that victory, that Wazari we saw him get. Van de Meyberg, we saw play earlier, and Zemanova. And up after this one, we'll want to watch this final between semifinal between Lipartigliani and Humini. We get a chance, we'll want to switch over to mat 2 after that match to see the Santos Junior Elbakiev semi between at 73 kilos between Brazil and Russia. But if you want, you can watch the last 18 seconds on mat 2. Megas frantically trying to overcome. Oh, nice by Van de Meyberg. Van de Meyberg with the Wazari. Zemanova tried to turn. Van de Meyberg came in with an attack, but Zemanova tried to counter. But Van de Meyberg retained control and brought Zemanova down. Zemanova was lucky that that wasn't a Nippon. Giving a review. I want to see exactly what occurred here. We have another situation here, Sheldon, where we had an attack and a counter, and then, okay, so they gave Zemanova the Wazari for that, but Van de Meyberg was trying to come through. Oh no, I'm sorry, Zemanova was trying to come through, and Zemanova did get it. Okay, Zemanova did get the Wazari.
Right, so, you know, when we review that, our role here is to say why.
Right.
Why is that? So I won't be looking at whether it's Van der Meyberg's score or not, because that's a moot point now. Right. It hasn't been given. All I'll be doing is to look and say, okay, why is it Zemanova's score? And once you've got that, you can then say why Van der Meyberg didn't get the score.
Well, my reading... Sorry, you're asking me for mine first?
No. Okay. You know, we'll watch the rest of the contest because it won't be until we get the replays again.
Yeah. Oh, again, trying to do the same kind of thing.
Yeah.
Oh, and she got the Ippon.
Well, we'll have a look here. They're going to review this. So, this action is going to be under review.
Yeah.
They'll have a look at this, and they'll see who initiates the action, whether the action is taken over, and whether it's valid for scoring purposes. So all of those things will be now considered. So what's the start of the action? Well, it's out of the area anyway.
Zemanova is lifting. Yeah. So I think Zemanova's action was continuous, but I don't see Van de Meyberg landing in an Ippon or even a Wazari position.
So there is, as far as you're concerned, no landing.
Okay.
For,
and they called it back.
Yeah. There's no landing for Zemanova,
but
to score on white.
Right.
And there's no end control for Van de Meyberg on Zemanova. So
right. Right.
And that one would have gone to White if she'd been able to. That was a simple one.
Right.
Yeah. It's not easy.
No,
it's not easy. And in some cases, the best thing to do is to say, well, there's no score.
Yeah, I never really thought that Vanda Meyburg really had a scoring opportunity there. It was just a question of whether Zimanova's finish was complete, and it wasn't. Whereas in the first one, it was. It was the same exact throw, but she did bring Vanda Meyburg over, and it was a continuous movement on Zimanova's part. So a good Wazari in that first instance. Oh,
she not quite. Yeah, she's all right. She had the arm there.
But she came down on her shoulder kind of hard.
Yeah, yeah. It is unfortunate.
Yeah. It's a feature of the sport. So, Zimanova still up by Wazari. Just over a minute.
And yet it's Vanda Meyburg that looks the more threatening of the two at the moment.
Well, she's got to.
Yeah.
You know, she can't just wait. So.
True.
And yet, Zimanova is not resting on her laurels here either. She may not be quite as aggressive, but here she is, really going after Zimanova's arm for the Jijigatame. And Zimanova is in a. Vanda Meyburg is in a bad place at the moment.
Yeah, losing.
Yeah. No, it's not a pin. She's not in a pinning position.
I know.
You can't call a pin when you're not in a pinning position. Oh, maybe it's the other side match. Where that's a semifinal going on mat two. Santos Jr. from Brazil. No. We're going to stay on mat one.
Yeah, we'll stay here because, to be honest, this is where the action is. We've got 30-odd seconds left of a really tight contest. And I've been looking across at that scoreboard and seeing two big zeros and Shido going up there, I thought, no, I'm not going there. Here's the time to go now.
Yep, 18 seconds, come on. And Zimanova might pick up a Shido here.
Yeah, it won't be any good, I'm afraid.
Yeah, and there is. It is a Shido. But 15 seconds, it's not going to. She could pick up another Shido and it's still
winning. Absolutely, and that was a poor effort from Vanda Meyburg. Didn't think about it. You've got one go. You're only going to have one go at it. It's got to be your best shot. And unfortunately, from Shannon Vanda Meyburg, she'll want to take that back and say, just give me one more go at that. I'll make a better effort. Unfortunately, you know, time's run out.
I think she was just exhausted.
And we're not going to go anywhere. We're going to stay on mat one, because Eteri Lipotiliani is coming up against Ku Mimi.
Right.
Next.
Right.
I think that's going to be a humdinger. Really is.
Yeah.
For me, you have to have a look and see who's on the other side, but this is going to be quite a matchup. Who, by the way, there are suspicions.